So welcome you once again for the discussion about carbonyl compound 2, in which I would like to cover reactions of compounds with alpha hydrogens. I mean, alpha hydrogens are acidic here, so that is why I mean these reactions have been compiled. That means aldol condensations, Perkins condensation, Claisen condensation, Dieckmann condensation, and Dargens condensation. In all these reaction mechanism, I mean the reactant molecules are having alpha hydrogens. Okay, so they undergo reactions. Okay, so in all the reaction mechanism, I have given mechanism of actions also. In that, I have clearly mentioning the step-by-step representation of the reaction. Okay. Okay, now let us here the carbonyl compounds aldehydes. I mean carbonyl compound containing aldehydes condense in the presence of dilute base to form the addition product like beta hydroxy aldehyde. So this is alpha positions. This one is beta positions. This is beta carbon. This is alpha carbonyl with respect to this carbonyl carbon of aldehyde. So therefore, this compound is called as beta hydroxy because hydroxyl group is attached to this I mean beta carbon, so therefore it is beta hydroxy aldehyde. So this product is called aldol. Okay, so aldol means I mean hydroxyl group containing I mean aldehyde compound. Okay, carbonyl compounds are aldehydes containing alpha hydrogens condense in the presence of dilute base. Okay, remember, so this will takes place in the alpha hydrogen takes place between the alpha hydrogen containing carbonyl aldehydes. Okay, carbonyl compounds. So particularly alpha hydrogen containing aldehydes. So methaldehyde. So this is a CH3 C double bond OH. Two molecules of I mean acetaldehyde condensed to give aldol product in presence of NaOH. Okay, in presence of dilute base. Okay, so this is I mean alpha position with respect to this carbonyl carbon. So therefore, this carbon is having three protons, three alpha hydrogens. So only this type of molecule, that means alpha hydrogen containing aldehyde molecule undergo aldehyde condensation. So let us move on to the mechanism of this aldol condensation. How it will take place. I mean, how this condensation reactions takes place. Let us go through this mechanism. So, as far as this mechanism concerned, so in the first step, I mean, hydroxide ion deprotonates the aldehyde. So this alpha protons are there now, which are more acidic here. So therefore, this hydroxide ion deprotonates the aldehydes. Okay, so hydroxide ion means it is base. So normally base will abstract I mean protons. Okay, so therefore this base I mean abstract protons, alpha protons from the acetaldehyde in this. okay, in the first stage. So that means due to this deprotonation, I mean enolate ion formation takes place. This is called enolate ion. So here this enolate adds to the unreacted aldehyde. So that means it will reacts on one more molecule of unreacted acetaldehyde. So that will give you this, I mean alkoxide molecule in the second stage. So this alkoxide ion is protonated by water. So in the third step, this will protonated by water, this alkoxide ion, okay, protonated by water. So which will give you, beta hydroxy aldehyde compound. So this protonations leads to this beta hydroxy, aldehyde compound. This is aldol. Okay, this small portion of aldehyde is again converted into enolate ion 4, and this enolate ion 4 loses hydroxyl ion to give alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde in the end. Okay, so this is all about the aldol condensation. Aldol condensation takes place in 5 steps. Okay, so that means the reaction takes place between 2 molecule of alpha proton, alpha hydrogen containing aldehydes. Okay, so here I have taken acetaldehyde as a best example. So in the first step, hydroxide ion deprotonates to give enolate ion. So that enolate ion reacts on the second unreacted acetaldehyde molecules to give alkoxide, and this alkoxide ion protonated by water to give beta hydroxy aldehyde, that is aldol molecule. So in the fourth step, a small amount of this aldol is again converted into enolate ion 4, and this enolate ion loses hydroxide ion to give alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde. So this is alpha positions and this is beta positions. Alpha carbon, beta carbon. This is beta carbon, this is alpha carbon. Therefore, it is said to be alpha beta unsaturated. Unsaturated means double bond or triple bond containing molecule. Carbon carbon double bonds or carbon carbon triple bond compounds are called unsaturated. Here, the double bond formation, takes place between the carbon carbon. That is why it is called alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde. Okay, so aldol to alpha beta unsaturated takes place. Small portion of aldol. Complete conversions will not take place. So therefore, this is also the byproduct of aldol condensation. Okay, so this is all about aldol reaction. So today we shall discuss about the one more reaction mechanism on aldehydes, that is Perkins condensation reactions. In this Perkins reactions, condensation reactions, unsaturated aromatic acid is going to form by the aldol condensation of an anhydride in the presence of an alkali salt of acids. So CH3COONa is alkali salt of acid. It is alkali salt acts as a base. Okay, so this is aliphatic acid anhydride. So this acid anhydride should have at least 2 alpha hydrogens. So this methyl group on either side of this anhydrides are having alpha hydrogens because it is attached to the carbonyl carbon. That is why it is called as alpha hydrogens. Okay, alpha hydrogens. Okay, both are totally six alpha hydrogens are there in this acidic anhydride. Okay, so suppose if we treat this acidic anhydride with benzaldehyde in presence of alkali salt, cinnamic acid formations takes place via aldol condensations. Okay, through aldol condensation. Okay, so Perkin's reaction has been effected between aromatic aldehydes and aliphatic anhydrides in the presence of sodium or potassium salt of acids. Okay, corresponding to the anhydride to yield alpha beta unsaturated aromatic compounds. So this is alpha beta unsaturated. This carbon is alpha to this carbonyl. So alpha and beta positions are represented on the based on the carbonyl group of particular compounds. Okay, so naming, I mean numbering will be given. Suppose this carbon is directly attached to the carbonyl carbon is alpha, so the second carbon is beta, like that, beta alpha, beta gamma, like that. So here alpha and beta positions, alpha and in between alpha and beta double bond is there, therefore it is alpha beta unsaturated aromatic acid it is. Okay, so this carbon is alpha carbon atom, this is beta carbon. Okay, first carbon is alpha, second carbon is beta, so therefore it is alpha beta unsaturated. Unsaturated means it has a double bond character. Okay, and now we shall move on to the mechanism, I think mechanism of action of Perkin's reactions. Okay, let us just go through the mechanism of Perkin's condensation. It takes place in three steps. Okay, in this reaction the carbon ion generation will be there, which is obtained by the removal of alpha hydrogens. As I said, in the anhydrides should have more than at least it should have two alpha hydrogens. Okay, so the in the first step the carbonyl ion is obtained by the removal of alpha hydrogen atom from the acid anhydride by carboxylate anion. Okay, so this acts as a base here, so this will abstract proton from the anhydride, so that carbon ion generations will be there. So carbon bearing negative charge is called carbon ion. Okay, so this is electron rich compound now, so therefore this carbon ion okay will attack on carbonyl carbon of aromatic aldehyde here. So carbonyl carbon is electron deficient center, so from this to this migration will be there, formation of bond between this carbon to carbon ion, carbon to carbonyl carbon takes place. Okay, so therefore this electron will move to oxygen. Okay, so therefore this oxygen carries a negative charge, so thereby alkoxide ions are generated here. Okay, so this is alkoxide anion. Okay, so this is less stable after one more, I mean transfer of acetyl group from I mean this carboxyl oxygen to, this is carboxyl oxygen, okay, so this to this, I mean transfer of I mean this acetyl group from carboxyl oxygen to alkoxy oxygen takes place, I mean this group transfer, okay, from this oxygen to this oxygen takes place, so thereby the formation of one more stable anion takes place, that is carboxyl anion, it is, okay, that is carboxylate, remember, so the earlier alkoxide anion formations will be there, so because of carbon ion attacks on carbonyl carbon of aromatic aldehyde, okay, so from this alkoxide anions are generated, this anions are less stable, therefore this migration takes place, transfer of acetyl group, so therefore one more stable anion generations are occurred, so that I mean carboxylate ion, okay, results in the loss of I mean good leaving group from the position to give anion of alpha beta unsaturated compound. So this is possible only after the removal of second alpha hydrogens, okay, so thereby I think this alpha beta unsaturated acid anion formations takes place, and this on acidifications, this on acidification means H plus ion, I mean addition of H plus ion to give alpha beta unsaturated acid, so this is cinnamic acid, so this takes place in three steps, first step carbon ion generations, second step this carbon ion attacks on carbonyl carbon, so followed by the transfer of acetyl group from carboxyl oxygen to alkoxy oxygen, so this will generate more stable anion, carboxylate anion, so this carboxylate anion will lose a good leaving group from the positions to give anion here, anion of alpha beta unsaturated, so in this third step I mean removal of acetate ion takes place, so thereby I mean alpha beta unsaturated acid, anion of alpha beta unsaturated acid formations takes place, so this on hydro I mean acidification gives alpha beta unsaturated acid, okay, this is all about your Perkins reactions. Okay, now let us move on to the another reactions of alpha hydrogen containing ketone. So this is Claisen-Schmidt condensations. Claisen-Schmidt condensation it is. Okay, reaction between the aldehydes or ketones having alpha hydrogen with aromatic carbonyl compound lacking an alpha hydrogen, okay, so this is an aldehydes or ketones having alpha hydrogen with an aromatic aldehydes, I mean aromatic carbonyl compounds lacking an alpha hydrogen, so this aromatic benzaldehyde, aromatic aldehyde like benzaldehyde is lacking an alpha hydrogen, acetone is having alpha hydrogens, okay, so reaction between these two is called Claisen Schmidt condensation. Okay, this reaction named after two of its pioneering investigators, Claisen and Schmidt, who's independently published on this topic in the year 1880 and 1881. So from these two reactant reacts to give, condensation reactions to give the benzylidine acetone molecule. Okay, this is called benzylidine acetone molecule. So now let us move on to its mechanism of actions, how it is, how this product formation takes place from the condensation reactions. Okay, so this is a reaction between the aldehyde or ketones are having alpha hydrogen with aromatic carbonyl compounds lacking an alpha hydrogens. Okay, so this is called Claisen-Schmidt condensations. This reaction takes place in 10% sodium hydroxide media, alkali media. Okay. Here this mechanism of reactions were explained in two steps. Okay, so in the first step, enolate ions are formed when a molecule with hydrogen alpha to the carbon group are treated with base. Remember, so sodium hydroxide, so this base hydroxyl ion abstract proton from the ketones or alpha hydrogen containing ketones or aldehyde molecules. Okay, so acetone reacts with base to give enolate. So in the first step, this enolate ion formation takes place when the enolate forms from the aldehyde. Okay, the enolate will normally reacts with the unreacted aldehyde to undergo aldol additions. So this enolate ion undergo aldol additions. So this enolate is having a negative charge, electron rich center it is, electron rich compound it is, so it will attach to carbonyl carbon of benzaldehyde here. So this enolate will normally reacts with unreacted aldehydes to undergo aldol additions or aldol condensation reactions. Okay, and again this ketones concerned, they are less reactive towards nucleophilic additions. Enolate formed from the ketone can be used to react with aldehyde. The modifications are called Claisen-Schmidt reaction it is. So even though there will be a ketones comparing with aldehydes, they are less reactive towards nucleophilic additions. So this kind of modifications still that forms an enolate and which will react on aldehydes. So this modification is called Claisen-Schmidt reactions. Okay, in cases where the product formed still has a reactive alpha hydrogens and hydroxide adjacent to an aromatic ring, the reaction will quickly undergo dehydration leading to the condensation product. Okay, so in case the product formed still has a reactive alpha hydrogens, remember, okay, still alpha hydrogens, still has a reactive alpha hydrogens in this molecule, remember, okay, hydroxide adjacent to the aromatic ring, the reaction will quickly undergo dehydration. Okay, so leading to condensation product. So totally overall this reaction takes place in two steps. In the first step, enolate ion formations in the presence of base. Okay, so when the enolate forms from the aldehydes the ketones normally react with unreacted aldehydes to undergo aldol additions or aldol condensation reactions. Okay, but in this Claisen-Schmidt reactions, the reactant starting material is taken as ketones. Since ketones are less reactive towards nucleophilic additions, and enolate formed from the ketone can be used to react with aldehyde, a modification it is, okay, called Claisen-Schmidt. Normally it is not possible, therefore this modification of reactions are called Claisen-Schmidt. Okay, otherwise aldehydes undergo, reaction with nucleophilic reactions with aromatic aldehydes. Okay, this is aldol addition or aldol condensation. But as far as this Schmidt reaction concerned, ketones undergo nucleophilic substitutions. Since ketones are less reactive towards nucleophilic additions, still this enolate undergo reaction with nucleophilic substitution reaction with aromatic aldehyde. This kind of modifications are called Claisen-Schmidt reactions. Okay, in case where the product forms still has a reactive alpha hydrogen. So the product, in case where the product formed still has a reactive alpha hydrogens. So it has two alpha hydrogens in this. Okay, still it has. Therefore, hydroxide adjacent to the aromatic ring. So this hydroxide group adjacent to the aromatic ring, the reaction will quickly undergo. Okay. Dehydrations leading to the condensation product. Suppose in the product, okay, formed still has reactive alpha hydrogen and hydroxide adjacent, these two, alpha hydrogen and hydroxide adjacent to aromatic ring, the reaction quickly undergo dehydration. I mean, dehydration means removal of water molecule here. Okay, leading to the condensation product. This one. Okay, alpha beta unsaturated ketone it is. Aromatic ketone it is. Okay, now let us move on to the one more reaction, Dieckmann condensation reaction. This Dieckmann condensation is a intramolecular chemical reaction of diester, okay, with base to give beta keto ester. Okay, will give beta keto ester. Remember, this is an Dieckmann condensation is an intramolecular chemical reaction of diester. Intramolecular means within a molecule chemical reactions takes place. Okay, so this is possible in diesters with base to give beta keto ester. Okay, the name, it is named after German chemist Dieckmann, the year 1869 to 1825. The equivalent intramolecular reaction is called Claisen condensation. Equivalent intermolecular, this is intra, okay, between the molecule it is called Claisen condensation. Okay, but now it is intramolecular chemical reactions. Intra, within this molecule takes place. Okay, only one reactant reacts to give, undergo, intramolecular chemical reactions, okay, with base to give beta keto ester. It is Dieckmann. Now let us move on to its mechanism of actions. Diethyl heptadienate gives 2-propanoyl cyclohexanone. 2-propanoyl cyclohexanone. Okay, after this intramolecular chemical reaction, cyclic ring formations takes place. Okay, remember, ethanol is the byproduct. Here two examples I have quoted. You can write any of one while asking for 2 marks questions, definitions and one example. Okay. It's a mechanism of actions, Dieckmann condensations. Okay. Here just see the mechanism is similar to that of Claisen reaction, condensation. Okay, strong base usually what it will do, removes protons, normally alpha protons, resulting in enolate. Remember, first the generation of enolate takes place. This enolate attacks the carbonyl carbon of another ester molecule in the diester. Okay, so that is why I think resulting cyclic beta keto ester in this reaction. Very simple reaction. It is a first step, enolate formations. Enolate, then attacks the carbonyl carbon of another ester molecule. That's it. Here, this enolate generation takes place in the first step, and this will attacks on the carbonyl carbon of one more ester group, carbonyl carbon of one more ester. Okay, so from this intramolecular chemical reaction, cyclic enolate formation takes place. Soon after, this beta keto ester generation takes place. Okay, only a two-step reaction it is, generation of enolate and then intramolecular chemical reactions with adjacent carbonyl group of ester. Okay, so this is what Dieckmann condensations. Okay, now let us move on to the Dargens condensations. Dargens reaction is the condensation of carbonyl compound with alpha haloester in the presence of base. This is an condensation of carbonyl compounds. Remember, any carbonyl compounds with alpha haloesters. So this is alpha haloester. So alpha carbon is having halogen atom in that, therefore it is alpha haloester it is. Okay, in the presence of base sodium ethoxide to form alpha beta epoxy ester. Alpha and beta carbons are bonded with oxygen, so this is what alpha beta epoxy ester. Now let us move on to its mechanism of action. Okay, so see here also generation of strong base used in the beginning, isn't it? As I said, sodium ethoxide as a strong base here. That strong base is used to form carbanion at the halogenated positions. Remember, so this will use to form a carbanion. This base, strong base, used to form the carbanion at the halogenated positions. Remember, so this will abstract proton in here. So thereby, enolate ions are generated. So this enolate ion is resonance stabilized. Okay, so this enolate. Okay, so because of the ester, this carbanion is the resonance stabilized enolate, remember, which makes it's relatively easy to form, and this nucleophilic structure attacks, remember, another molecule of carbonyl components. So this will attack on another carbonyl component of the another carbonyl compound, means another carbonyl molecule. Okay, forming new carbon-carbon bonds. Okay, so these first two steps, remember, are similar to base catalyzed aldol reactions only. These two steps, almost, it is similar to base catalyzed aldol reactions. Remember, so the next, in the next step, epoxide formation takes place via SN2 mechanism. Remember, the oxygen anion, remember, in this aldol-like product, then does an intramolecular SN2 attack on the formerly nucleophilic halide bearing positions. Formerly nucleophilic halide bearing positions. Remember, so this oxygen anion in this aldol-like product then does an intramolecular SN2 attack on the formerly nucleophilic halide bearing positions. This one, nucleophilic bearing halogen, nucleophilic bearing, nucleophile bearing, nucleophilic halide bearing position. It is okay. Displacing halide to form an epoxide. Displacing halide, I mean by the removal of halide to form an epoxide. This reaction sequence is thus a condensation reaction, since there is a net loss of HCl when two reactant molecules join. Remember, in the first step, H plus ion, removal of H plus ion will be there. In the third step, Cl, removal of Cl will be there. Therefore, total overall the HCl removal of, net loss of HCl takes place during this product epoxide formation. Okay, so when the two reactant molecules join. As I said, the reaction process begins when the strong base is used to form carbon ion at the halogenated positions. Remember, this base picks up a proton from this molecule. That means strong base is used to form carbon ion at the halogenated positions. Remember, okay, this one. This will fix up, base will fix up, this protons only. Okay, this is more acidic, remember. So, because of an ester, this carbon ion is resonance stabilized enolate, which makes it relatively easy to form. Okay, so this nucleophilic structure attacks to the another carbonyl component. Okay, forming new carbon-carbon bond in this. So from this reaction, so enolate with another new carbonyl compound molecule. Okay, so forming a new carbon-carbon bond. Okay, these two steps are similar to base catalyzed aldol reaction. The later step, the oxygen anion, so this oxygen anion in this aldol like product then does an intramolecular SN2 attack on the formerly nucleophilic halide bearing positions. This one, this is a nucleophilic halide bearing positions, where this oxygen anion reacts. So this reaction sequence is just condensation reaction, since there is a net loss of HCl, net loss of HCl when the two reactant molecule joins. Okay, so this is how I think epoxide formation takes place in the Dajan reactions. Thank you. Thank you for listening my lecture. Yeah. Any queries or any doubts in this presentations, you can directly you can ask. And my WhatsApp number, so that I can convey the solutions of those queries. Okay, my WhatsApp number is 9481 460 621. Thank you.